The A320 family has two ATC transponders, which transmit several parameters upon ground request, depending on the installed system. Refer to your documentation. These parameters can be speed, Mach, and barometric vertical speed data from the ADRs. Heading, roll, ground speed, track and inertial vertical speed data from the IRs. Selected altitude and barometric reference settings from the FCUs. On the version studied here and in its normal operation, the different parameters are transmitted to ATC1 by ADR1, IR1 and FCU1. ATC2 by ADR2, IR2 and FCU2. Note, in case of ADR1 or 2 failure, the ADR3 can be used through the air data switching selector as shown. A control panel located on the pedestal allows the installed and the selected ATC transponder to operate. It allows also the crew to enter the code assigned by the ATC. An altitude reporting selector allows the selected ATC transponder to send the barometric standard altitude data. The mode selector allows, when it is in standby, to electrically supply both ATCs, but to keep them in standby. In on, the selected ATC operates in all modes. In audio, if on ground, the selected ATC operates only in mode S, selective aircrafts and irrigation mode. If in flight, the selected ATC operates in all modes. On the A320 family, and independently of the ATC system, a traffic alert and collision avoidance system TCAS is installed and allows to detect any transponder-equipped aircraft and flying in the vicinity within a maximum range of 80 nautical mile and within a maximum altitude range of 9,900 feet to display potential and prediction of collision and to issue vertical orders to avoid conflict. The ATC control panel located on the pedestal also allows the control of the TCAS system. The TCAS part of this panel has a mode selector which allows the operation of the TCAS in standby or in TA when the aircraft performances are degraded, vertical order will be not generated, or in TRAE, which is the normal selection. A traffic selector which displays proximate and other intruders within an altitude range which depends on this selection. The normal selection is all. The A320 TCAS interrogates the transponder of the intruders and determines for each its relative bearing, its range and closure rate, and its relative altitude if equipped with ATC mode C or S. Then, the TCAS computes the intruder trajectory with the estimated time before reaching the closest point of approach. Each time, the relative position of the intruder shows a collision threat. Oral and visual advisories are triggered. Visual advisories are displayed on both NDs. The oral alert and vertical orders ensure a sufficient trajectory separation and a minimal vertical speed variation, taking into account all intruders. All the ND rose modes and ND arc mode can be used to display only the 8 most threatening intruders. The intruders are classified as shown. Proximate. No collision threat, but this intruder is in the vicinity of the aircraft. Traffic advisory, TA, with a potential collision threat and associated oral alert.
Traffic.
Resolution advisory, RA, with a real collision threat and associated oral alert.
Climb.
The vertical orders are displayed on the PFD to fly the green sector. Other intruders with no collision threat, but they are in the detection envelope and do not belong to any of the above intruders. Note, on the MD, The arrow indicates the vertical speed and the number indicates the relative altitude. On the PFD, the vertical speed scale is now rectangular, the vertical speed needle is now white, and the color of the digits depends on the green or red area. Traffic advisories, or resolution advisories, are associated to a related RL alert, depending on the situation. They can be
Traffic.
When only TA is detected.
Climb.
When the current vertical speed is below the green area.
Climb, crossing climb.
As the previous alert, and indicates that you will cross through the intruder altitude.
Increase climb.
If the climb vertical speed is not sufficient for a safe vertical separation.
Descend.
When the current vertical speed is above the green area.
Descend, crossing descend.
As for the same climb alert.
Increase descent.
As for the same climb alert.
Adjust vertical speed.
In order to stay in the green area, by reducing the climb or descent vertical speed.
Climb now.
When descending, and the intruder trajectory has changed.
Descend now.
As for the same climb alert.
Monitor vertical speed.
To ensure that the vertical speed will not enter the red area.
Maintain vertical speed. Maintain.
To keep the vertical speed in the green area.
Maintain vertical speed. Crossing maintain.
As for the previous alert, and indicates that you will cross through the intruder altitude.
Clear of conflict.
No more problems, and you may return to the assigned clearance. If the MD is in plan mode, and a traffic advisory or resolution advisory is detected.
Traffic.
A message is displayed on the MD to draw the pilot attention. Note, depending on the advisory level TA or RA, the ND message will be in amber or in red. In ROSE or ARC mode, and if a TA or RA is detected, a message is also displayed when the MD range is above 40 nautical mile to draw the pilot to select an appropriate range. Note, depending on the advisory level, TA or RA, the ND message will be in amber or in red. A green MIMO TCAS standby is displayed if the TCAS mode selector is on standby position. Or if the ATC mode selector is on standby position. Or if ALT reporting selector is set to off. Or if both ATC transponders or both radio altimeters have failed. Note, depending on the installed TCAS version and in flight, if TCAS standby has been selected, the MIMO message will be in amber, and an ECAM caution message will be triggered for crew awareness. If TCAS system is faulty, an amber indication is displayed on the PFDs and on the MDs, associated to one ECAM caution message for crew awareness. Note, depending on the installed TCAS version on the PFD and ND, the TCAS message can be in red.